In this video, we're going to talk about PXPLOT application that comes with XFOIL when you download it and how we can create plots from polar dump files. Let's get to it. So let's start out real quick with a discussion on what PXPLOT application is. If you look here in the folder that you download when you get XFOIL, you'll find that the PXPLOT application is in there with it. And so that is designed to work with the XFOIL application. Normally what happens is in XFOIL, when you are running a series of analysis, you might specify before you start the series that you want to write out to a polar dump file. And then when you run your series of analysis, it's going to save the data into the dump file, at which point you can pass it to your coworker or use it yourself at a later time. And to do that, you might go back into XFOIL and then navigate through all the menus, reload the polar dump file, and then navigate through the menus again to try and find what plots you want to create. However, this usually involves having to go through specifying some of the settings again or navigating through a lot of different menus. So this PXPLOT is designed to kind of streamline that process of going from polar dump files to plotting. And so instead of having to try and find your way through a bunch of menus, you can just go straight into the PXPLOT, choose some of the points you want to plot, choose what plot you want to create, and boom, it's done. And that's what we're going to cover in the next couple slides. All right, so first things first, let's go ahead and create a polar dump file. I went ahead and created a list here of the commands that I use to create the dump file. I talk more about them in my other video, so I've got a video on the basics of polar plots, and I've got another one on the basics of polar save and polar dump files. So I'll go ahead and leave links in the description below and probably on the end card as well. So check those out if you're wanting a little bit more information on what these commands are. I'm just going to list them here and move on because we've covered it before. The next step is to open the command prompt on your computer. Now the PXPLOT application does not actually have its own built-in GUI to it. You have to run it from the command prompt. And so on this step, we're going to go ahead and on our computer, find the command prompt and open it. I'm using a Windows computer, so that usually just means going down to the Start button, typing in command prompt to search for it, and then selecting it out of the list of the results. When you find it, go ahead and double-click to open up a command prompt window. After the command prompt opens, the next step is that you want to navigate to the folder where you have the XFOIL application and the PXPLOT application and the PPLOT application. So if you look here at the command prompt that I opened, it has the current location right here on the left of the caret, and it's sitting there waiting for you to enter in a command and hit enter. So the command we want to use is cd, which stands for change directory. And so we'll type in cd, and then we'll type in the path for the XFOIL folder that has the application inside of it. So on my computer, I have a folder on the C drive called XFOIL 6.99. Yours is probably going to be in a different location. Go ahead and type in whatever path is specific for your computer to get to that folder. After I typed it in and hit enter, you can see that the location or current directory has changed to the location I specified. This is important because in a future step, when we type PXPLOT, it's going to be looking in the current folder that you're in for the application. So if you're in the wrong folder, it's not going to see the application. Moving on to the next step, we're going to go ahead and start the PXPLOT application by typing in PXPLOT and hitting enter at the command prompt. When you do that, you'll notice that there's an error message afterwards that says error opening polar dump file. I get this every time. Supposedly, you're able to type in the polar dump file that you want to open right there on the same line that you type in PXPLOT. Just have a space in between. I've never gotten it to work myself, so I usually just skip that. I start PXPLOT, and then I'll use one of the menu options later to go ahead and load the dump file. And actually, that's going to be the next step here on this slide. So you'll see here I have the menu circled. This is the main menu, the top level menu. You can see there the third item is load polar dump file, so that's what we're going to use. After I type PXPLOT and hit enter, then I'll hit 3 and hit enter, and you'll see that it will ask you for the polar dump file name that you want to load. You want to make sure that you type in exactly what you did when you were specifying in XFOIL that you wanted to save a polar dump file. For instance, if you had polar dump file .txt, you definitely want to make sure that you remember to put the .txt on there. For some reason, if you don't match up what you do when you create the polar dump file, it has an issue trying to load it back in. So if you specified it with a .dat, or if you left it blank, or if you did a .txt, you have to make sure you do the same thing here when you try and load it. Since when I created the polar dump file back in step one, I did polar dump file.txt. So here, when I try and load it, I'm going to also type in polar dump file.txt and hit enter. And you'll notice that there is no error message saying that it had an issue, and it spits us right back onto the top menu. That means it's succeeded. It has loaded our polar dump file. Okay, so we started PXPLOT and loaded our dump file. The basic way that the PXPLOT works is that you select what points in the dump file that you want to plot, and then you select what plot that you want to create, and it will create the new window with that plot. Since we're here at this point that we started PXPLOT and loaded the polar dump file, the next step would be to select the points that we want to plot. If you look at this main menu, the first option is the one that we want to do to select points. So if I type 1 and hit enter, you'll see it will then list all of the points that are available in the dump file for you to choose from. And we're just going to select them based on the angle of attack. At the command prompt where it asks you to enter the alphas of the points to be plotted, go ahead and type in the points that you want. Here I just selected 0, 4, 8, 12, and 16. I just left them separated by a space. So if you type them all in and hit enter, it will then ask you again if there's any alphas that you want to be plotted. I'm not entirely sure why it does this. I don't know if this is a bug or if that's just meant to give you a second chance to enter in anything you might have forgotten. But if you just hit enter again, then it will show you the points that you selected out of the polar dump file. And these are the points that's actually going to be plotted. And it puts us right back at the main menu. Now that we've selected the points that we want to plot, time to select the plot that we wish to create. On the main menu, you'll notice that is option number 2. So if you type 2 and hit enter, it will once again remind you of the points that you have selected. But underneath that, it will give you a list of the different plots that are available that you can see here on numbers 1 through 9. And so if I want to, for instance, plot the CP versus X, I would type in 2 and hit enter, and then it will create the CP versus X plot. Similarly, if I wanted to do the coefficient of friction versus X, then if I hit 7 and hit enter, it will plot the CF versus X. It's as simple as that. You load the file, select the points, select the plot. Now there are some additional options or settings. The annotate current plot just gives you the option to annotate the figure, similar to the previous video I did on annotating plots. Hard copy current plot is there to be able to save a picture of the plot. And then there, of course, is some settings that you can change as well. I'm going to go ahead and end the video there. I will see you in the next video.